Well, that was a waste of time, guys. Sorry about that. I made a second call and waited on hold for 27 minutes and 35 seconds with no resolution. I think they just put me on hold and I eventually come back hoping I'm going to hang up. And then they will transfer you and then you're gone. So just be paid, you know, be forewarned. You guys are an AP. You have to deal with these people. Just be forewarned. Brutal company. Brutal. They're lucky they're even in business. SAT, if that goes by the boards, they got all they got is AP. All right, a little decompression here. So, this table of random digits, I'm going to show you. We have it in the back of the book. Okay, and that's what we're going to use. Okay, so you'll see it right here. It's called Table D. Okay, and it's just a table of random digits. Now, you're going to have problems like this on a quiz or a test, and what they will do is they will give you the table that they want you to use, okay? I'm actually fearful this song is going to have some bad lyrics. Alexa, skip. So they will give you an excerpt of a table to use so that the answers will be the same for everybody if done correctly, okay? So as you can see, this is a long string of numbers. Okay, and it starts in line 101 and it goes all the way down here to line 150. And I don't know if it goes on the other page or not. Let's see. No, it doesn't. That's plenty. We'll never go past that, okay? Each number is supposedly equally as likely, and the entries are independent of each other. So just because there's a 1 there doesn't mean you couldn't have a 1 right after it. There's repeated numbers throughout the table, okay? So the two steps. Number one, label and give each member a numerical label of the same length. Okay, so if you have 10 or under things, okay, 10 or under, then you should use one digit, okay, and you'd have to number them or label them 0 to 9. Okay, if you have 11 items, you can't use 0 to 9, and you can't say, okay, 0 to 10, and then 11 is something else. You can't do that, okay? All of your labels have to have the same digits, because otherwise they don't come up the same when you're looking for them, okay? So if you need 2-digit labels, then they all need to be 2-digit. If you need 3-digit, then they all need to be 3-digit. But it's best when you only have a 1-digit, because then you can get through it a lot faster. And I'll show you what that means in a minute. We have an example to try. Okay, so read consecutive groups of digits from the appropriate length from table. Always use the shortest labels. That's what I was just talking about. You always, if you can use just that, if you only have 10 or under, then you want to use that. Okay, 0 to 9, 1-digit. But otherwise, you can't. So it says, the management company of a local mall plans to survey a random sample of 3 stores to determine the hours they would like to stay open during the holiday season. Use table D at line 101 to select an SRS of size 3 stores. So you guys are gonna do this now. I'm gonna have you guys do this so we can check it. It's a good example for you, okay? So the way that you start this is you start here. The first one is 19, okay? Right there, 19. So you look at 19, Star Jewelers. You would write that down, okay? And then the next number is 22. 22 is not in my list. We have to ignore that. So you have 19, you have 22. The next one's 39. Not in my list. You ignore that. And that's the process that you go through. So I want you guys to do that. Pause the video, okay? And I want you to try that and see what are the 3 stores that you get. I told you the first one. The first one's Star Jewelers, okay? So pause the video. Give it a shot. We'll go over the answers in a second. All right, so hopefully you guys completed that. You picked out your, so I'm just gonna go through what would have happened had you done this, okay? I did this on another piece of paper. So 19 was Star Jewelers, okay? And then you have 22, 39, 50, 34. Those are the next digits in that table, and we had to skip all those. And the reason we had to skip those is because it doesn't show for one of the stores, okay? After 34, the next one that came up is 05, and that is a store, okay? That is Carter's for Kids. Carter's. Okay, and this one was Star Jewelers. So we have Star Jewelers, we have Carter's. After 05, the next number is 75, and then it's 62, and then it's 87, and all of those numbers are not on my list, so we just skip those. We go right over those. And then the next one is 13, Mrs. Fields. Oh, it's quite a store. Okay, they have chocolate chip cookies that are good there. They're good. Okay, so those are your three stores. That's how you use our table of random digits. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. Hopefully that makes sense. All right, stratified random sample. So this simple random sample, okay, strengths and weaknesses, we're gonna talk about it a little bit. I'm gonna talk about it right now. Everybody gets an equal chance. Everybody gets an equal chance. So if we had everyone in our school, everybody gets a number, and you select a sample of, say, 20 people. Now, it's possible that you get 20 boys and 0 girls. Now, very, very unlikely, okay? But it's possible. It could happen. I could also get 20 freshmen and get nobody from any of the other classes. Again, highly, highly unlikely, but still possible. So in a simple random sample, everybody has an equal chance of being selected. Okay. Now, sometimes that's not viewed as a good thing, because some groups get overrepresented. So sometimes you will see people move away from a simple random sample and try to find something that they view as better. And so that's the next one that we're going to talk about. The next one is a stratified random sample. Okay, and we got it right here. Okay, so what the stratify would be, like, let's say we wanted to find out some opinion about something at school, how the remote learning is going, or whatever, I don't know, lunches at school, okay, or what classes are offered. How about that? Classes to add to the course catalog. Well, if we took a survey and we ended up getting 20 people and they were all juniors and seniors, then the views of the group, the things would be twisted in favor of upperclassmen. So what they have is they have a stratified random sample. Ahead of time, the people that are doing this survey understand that classes that are important to freshmen are different than classes that are important to seniors, and vice versa, okay? So what they do is they put them into groups first. Okay, so they put freshmen in one group, and then they put sophomores in another group, and they put juniors in another group, and then seniors in a different group. And then what you do is you randomly select from each of those groups. So if you were taking 20, you might take 5 freshmen randomly, 5 sophomores randomly, 5 juniors randomly, and 5 seniors randomly. And then you get a group of people that has, where all of the groups, okay, are equally represented. Okay, you've got freshmen, you've got sophomores, you've got juniors, you've got seniors. You can make a decision everyone has a say, okay? That's stratified, okay? And it talks about here, works best when they're similar in a way that affects the response, okay? So that's why you set up the strata. So it says here, if doing a sleep study of sleep habits on school nights, the population of students may be divided freshmen, sophomore, junior, senior, just what we were talking about, okay? Because they think that freshmen might get more or less sleep than seniors for whatever reason, okay? If you're doing a pre-election poll, you might want to talk to people, split groups like urban, suburban, and rural, okay? Urban is like in the cities, rural is like in the woods, okay, pretty much, and then suburban is like in between. And they might want people from each of those surveying and getting opinions from each of those before making any decisions, okay? So why are stratified samples better? Congress was proposing a massive change to the Social Security program. Age is a good variable when forming strata. Older people have different views than younger people, okay? So using age will give you a better estimate of everybody's opinion. Okay, if you get all old people on there, then the decisions made are going to be favoring the old people. If you had all young people and they didn't care about the older people, then the opinions would be favoring them. So getting stratified is balancing that out. Okay. Now, although using a stratified sample can give more precise info than a simple random sample, which is SRS, they're both hard to use when populations are large, okay? So there are other ways that we can do this, and one is called a cluster sample, okay? So a cluster sample is when you take the population and to make a smaller group, you mix the groups ahead of time. So you might think of like advisories. This is an example I always use to explain the cluster samples. When we used to have advisories, in our advisories, you usually had a good mix. You had some freshmen in there, you had some sophomores in there, you had some juniors in there, you had some seniors in there. So we had these clusters, which is each of those is called a cluster. We had these clusters all over the building. And rather than making an announcement and doing a stratified sample where you might say, okay, we're gonna page these freshmen, these sophomores, these juniors, these seniors, they're all gonna come down and they're gonna take a survey. Well, that's a pain and it's difficult to execute. Whereas if you wanted to get the information from people, you might have looked at the advisory groups as clusters, okay? And in those clusters, you had like all these advisories, say there was 20 of them. You might say, okay, I'm gonna randomly choose 3 of those advisories and I'm gonna go survey all the people in those advisories, okay? That's what a cluster sample is, okay? It's still random, but it's easier to execute because you're going to groups that have already been mixed. Okay, they've already been mixed, and then you have all these groups that have been mixed, okay? And I, again, like the advisory groups, there's 20 advisory groups. They all have freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and seniors, boys and girls. And they all of these 20 groups, you randomly choose 3 of them, and then you send 3 people to those classes to get the information, to get the survey. That's a cluster sample, okay? So the difference between stratified and cluster sampling. So you have a part-time job as a salad quality inspector. So you sit there and you're looking at a salad bar or whatever and you're trying to inspect it for its quality, all right? Which type of sampling is better, okay? Is it best to take a small sample of each of the different things? So you might have a bin of the lettuce and then a bin of the cucumbers and all that stuff. So you don't want to take a cluster sample and only inspect tomatoes, carrots, and a bowl of ranch. You probably want a good mix there, okay? So that is that. My notes are not out of order, but we're going to talk about this next, okay? However, in a fast food restaurant where salads are prepared ahead of time, where they're already made into these clusters, okay, it probably makes sense if you have all these salads that are made up already. You get 20 salads, and you might just say, okay, I'm going to pick that salad, and I'm going to inspect the whole thing. I'm going to look at the whole part of the salad, the lettuce, the tomatoes, everything. Okay, that's an example of a cluster sample. So this one talks about systematic random sampling. Now, systematic random sampling is like if you have, and this happens with sports a lot, okay? You have a gym class and you have 30 people lined up and you go, okay, guys, I'm gonna count off by 5s. And I'm gonna put the 1s in one group and the 2s in another group and the 3s in another group and the 4s in another group. And so you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. The 1s are over here, the 2s are over here, the 3s are over here, the 4s are over there. That is a systematic random sample. Okay, you get it set up ahead of time. I'm gonna count off by 5s, count off by 6s, by 7s, by whatever's that you figure out, okay? So you guys are gonna do these, okay? You guys are gonna do these. I'm not gonna do them with you. I want you guys to do that and remind me to go over these answers, okay? This is new. This is new from last year, 2019, okay? So it's kind of new to my notes, so I may forget that, all right? So I need you guys to do these and then we'll talk about them. And maybe we just do them now. Let's see. Yeah, I guess we do. All right, so I want you guys to pause the video and give these a shot, and then we'll look at the answers shortly. Let me get my answer key.